If you were here for my last segment, then that was Vogue, Madonna. We also played some Ice Ice Baby. We played Eazy-E and a few other throwbacks, because this is my Throwback Weekend, and today it is all about the 90s. So if you missed it, we had talked about past toys and whether or not they were cool or not cool. So now we're going to talk about fashion, cool or not cool. So bleached hair or frosted tips, I think if it's done right, that it can look very cool. Now, I'm not suggesting that you go into your sink with a bottle of bleach or Clorox, throw your head in, and just hope that you get it right. I'm saying go have it done at a salon by a professional. Overalls with, like, one strap hanging down or both hanging down or both on, whether it's got buttons, those, oh, I love seeing, like, celebrities. I know Camila Cabello did it. I know Selena Gomez has done it a few times. Gigi Hadid has probably done it. There are several celebrities who have done that look, and it looks great. The one pant leg rolled up, I don't think I've ever seen that. I think I'd have to see it to know whether or not it was cool. A wide-legged JNCO jeans. I don't know. That's another one that I'd have to see to know if they were cool or not cool. Neon windbreakers. I've never seen this. A lot of these I haven't seen. Genera hypercolor tees. Those actually looked really cool. I would love to own one. Zubaz, I've never seen. Baja hoodies, Bogle Boy gear, and Big Dog shirts. I've probably seen them, but don't know what they are. So, right now, I'm going to play you an old commercial that I found for the Genera Hypercolor t-shirts. It's about 30 seconds long, and then when we get back, I'm gonna have someone I love come on, possibly, and tell us if he likes some of these fabulous 90s trends.
Guess what? Hypercolor clothing changes color with heat. Like this. Get it?
That was the Genera Hypercolor commercial. It was 30 seconds. The reason why I like the t-shirts is because when you added heat to them, they changed color, and I've always found that really cool. They do it with cups and phone cases and laptop cases, and they do it to a lot of things now, but I think I would really love to have a shirt that did that, though I think I'd have to be careful not to wear it when I'm going out running or anything. So I'm going to play a couple more 90s hits, then I want to talk to you guys about some other activities and random 90s things. Here's Vision of Love with Mariah Carey.
Treated me kind. Destiny.
So we're back, and there are three activities from the 90s that are really cool, and I want to talk about them before I play a couple more songs and talk about random 90s stuff, like the McDonald's McNugget Buddies. Just sounds random, right? So the third most popular activity in the 90s were the Skip-Its. For those of you who don't know what a Skip-It is, which I didn't know until I had to ask somebody, and then I'm like, oh, I remember those now. They're kind of like those one-person jump ropes. You put it on your ankle, and you would spin it with your ankle, and you would try to jump over it. The second one was a hacky sack, which was a ball that you kicked around, as I'm told. There's probably a lot more to it, but that's what I was told. And the number one thing, and I know a couple people who love doing this activity, is rollerblading. Now, when they first came out, a few people were like, I don't think you could, I'd want to do that, seems complicated. But, like, little kids thought it was the newest extreme sport, and they started playing street hockey, and adults did it to enjoy a new quote-unquote cool way to get some exercise. I wonder how many kids got embarrassed that their parents were roller skating down the street. Now, you could totally keep your Discman and your fanny pack so you could listen to your favorite boy band while gliding around on the streets, which was another bonus of rollerblading. So, when we come back, I'm going to tell you about an experience that I had going rollerblading with my stepdad, which was fun, but I actually kind of learned something about him that was pretty cool. The next songs I'm going to play are You Can't Touch This, Nothing Compares to You, and a few more old school hits.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Touch this. Yeah, that's how we living, and you know, can't touch this. Look in my eyes, man, you can't touch this. Yo, let me bust the funky lyrics. Touch this. Fresh new kicks and bands, you got it like that, now you know you wanna dance. So move out of your seat and get a fire going and catch this beat while it's rolling. Hold on, pump a little bit and let the noise go on like that, like that. Yo, sound the bell, school is in, sucker. You can't touch this. Give me a song, a rhythm, making them sweat. That's what I'm giving them now. They know, you talk about the hammer, you're talking about a show that's hot and tight. Singles are sweating so fast, I'm a white boy tape. To learn, what's it gonna take in the 90s to burn the charts? Legit, either work hard or you might as well quit. That word, because you know, you can't touch this. You can't touch this. Touch this. You better get a hype, boy, cause you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down. Stop. Have a time. Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Break it down. Stop. Have a time. Every time you see me, the hammer's just so hype. I'm going. Hammer, go hammer, empty hammer, yo hammer, and the rest can't go in play. Can't touch this.